Deputy Donnelly.
Thank you, Ken Corlett. Taoiseach, we're halfway through committee stage on the new Freedom of Information legislation. Now, it is true that the new bill contains some meaningful reforms, but unfortunately, all of the potential good that this bill could do is going to be eradicated by changes to the fees regime. Now, Taoiseach, I believe that your government set out to do the right thing when Fianna Fáil sought to eradicate the Freedom of Information regime in 2003. Here's what then Deputy Richard Bruton said. He said there would be a right to make requests without a fee up front, with a person only paying for the cost incurred by his or her request. In 2003, here's what then Deputy Pat Rabbit said. It is abundantly clear that the fee is primarily intended to discourage requests being made in the first instance. In 2008, here's what then Deputy Alex White said. The presumption in any democratic society should be to make the information available. It is not good enough for a minister to point to the extraordinary cost or how onerous it is on us. Taoiseach, the proposed changes in this legislation are contrary to the position of the UN Human Rights Committee and the Council of Europe's Convention on Access to Official Documents. And international experts are no more ambiguous. Article 19, Taoiseach, is a human rights organisation that focuses on freedom of information. And they said they strongly oppose the current Irish policy, as well as the pending bill before the Dáil to expand fees. They believe that it violates international law. A Canadian journalist and author, Cory Doctorow, said the following. Irish politicians have taken extraordinary measures to protect the state from the people finding out what it's up to. This is alarming on its face and would be bad news even if Ireland was a paragon of good governance and not a nation in economic meltdown.
Question, please.
Taoiseach, your government's new bill introduces a range of new charges and impediments. It retains the upfront fee of €15 for non-personal records. It contains a retrieval cost of €21 an hour. It introduces multiple fees for multifaceted requests. It introduces multiple fees for single requests that have to go to more one functional area. It retains a fee for internal appeal, and it retains a fee for appeal to the Information Commissioner. In short, Taoiseach, the legislation for freedom of information before the committee is going
to
make freedom of information more expensive. So my question to you is this. Why are you increasing costs for freedom of information when domestic experts and international experts are clear and unanimous on how bad that is, and when we have unparalleled information on how and why secrecy is bad in this state? Thank you.
Thank you.
Taoiseach. We've had national experts and international experts available to us by the thousand on so many things. It's quite incredible. They've been out, you know, telling us what was going to happen about the economy and all the matters related to Europe for a very long time. Sometimes experts themselves don't get it right either. Now, I think, Deputy Donnelly, the first point is correct here. Government Minister Howland has extended the remit of the Freedom of Information Act to a whole range of areas that were not covered before. I think that's welcome. I think it should also be borne in mind that 70% of the applications that come in to Freedom of Information officers are related to personal matters, and they're always free. I think it's also recognised that the first 2 hours of any analysis of a Freedom of Information request is also free. And if the issues involved can be dealt with in that, there is no charge at all. The position that, I'm informed from many Freedom of Information officers is that a page comes in about an issue, and that it might contain 20 requests or 40 requests, which, if you like, on the basis of them being hidden behind the principle of one request, could take up a very great length of time on whoever has to deal with it in the government department. And it's for that reason that the itemised charge would apply if the cost is, if the time is over 2 hours, and if it's not related to a personal matter, which is of course remains to be free. So I think, I recall when I was over there, one of the deputies put in a request, I think, to deal with a justice matter, and the estimated cost of dealing with it was over 9,000, because it was a very complex case going back quite a number of years. So I think, Deputy Donnelly, people are fully entitled to send in their requests and for freedom of information. But I think when you get lists of things that are completely unrelated on one page, obviously the view taken is that these things are separate matters and that therefore are separate requests. If any of those require less than 2 hours, there is no charge. If any of them are related to personal matters, there are no charge either. So it's a case of it's a case of reflecting that reality. And the extension of the Freedom of Information Act to reverse what happened before, cabinet records, communications between ministers, the scope to withholding all records during the deliberative process, and the mandatory blanket extensions that were there for security, defence and international relations matters. The freedom of information reverses a great deal of these. I think that's in the public interest.
Thank you. Deputy Donnelly, 1 minute. Thank you.
Thank you for your reply, Taoiseach, but unfortunately you didn't answer my question. The only rationale we seemed to get from Minister Brendan Howland yesterday was that at a time of economic hardship, we can't make freedom of information, which is an essential part of any modern democracy, free. Well, we have a report here, a very thorough report from Dr. Nat O'Connor, which estimates that the cost of charging the money is at least as much as the money you get. That's before you factor in a lot of the savings we get from good work, investigative journalism done, which saves the state millions, as we know. So there's no argument that says we have to charge fees because it costs money, because it costs as much money to charge the fee as the fee itself. And therefore, my question stands. If there is no cash benefit to the state of charging citizens to access information in their own state, why are we charging them? And why are you standing over legislation that is going to increase the cost of people getting that information?
Thank you.
That's the question, Taoiseach. Thank you.
As I said to you already, 70% of the claims that come in are for personal information. They are free. If an issue comes in where there's a claim for a freedom of information request, and it's about a single issue, if it takes less than 2 hours to deal with that, there is no charge either. But clearly, the legislation also points out, Deputy Donnelly, that on a single request, if there are other requests on that page that are related to the single request, well, then that's all part of the one claim, if you like. But clearly, it appears as if you have significant numbers of claims coming in with unrelated matters that are put in under the one claim in the first instance. Now, other countries that are deemed not to have upfront charges have different charges along the process. So I think I should repeat again to you that we've changed elements of what were blocked off here before in regard to some of the areas that were off limits for a very long time, including the NTMA, NAMA, the Garda Síochána, refugee agencies, and a very broad range of quasi-judicial bodies to which FOI previously only applied to their administrative records. That's all being opened up. So I think as the new legislation takes effect, Deputy, a €15 charge out of the average cost of retrieving information is about 600, is relatively small. And I do think that when people are making their claims, that they focus on a single issue with related matters or a whole series of different issues. And it's for that reason, in extending the remit of the freedom of information, that the legislation is framed in the way that it is.
Thank you. That completes leaders' questions for today.